This video explains the Widlar current mirror and source, following the description Widlar himself gave in the paper Some Circuit Design Techniques for Linear Integrated Circuits. In the early 60s, the planar process and the integrated circuit were a recent achievement. It was clear to everyone that through integrated circuit, you could pack a huge number of components in a small piece of silicon, and that was the future. But design for integrated circuit wasn't like a design with discrete components. In that period, and for more than a decade, a man called Bob Widlar, or the analog wizard, gave a huge contribution in defining the new way of designing. One of his most known legacy is the Widlar current mirror or current source. One of the first challenges in integrated circuit design was forming a small current in the order of microamperes, because of the relatively large resistor value usually required. However, with this circuit taken from the Widlar patent of 1967, it's possible to create a current source with the output in the tens of microamperes using resistances of only few kiloohms. Putting the circuit in a more familiar way, we have this, where we see that the base emitter voltage of T1 is used to bias the transistor T2, which has the resistor R2 in its emitter. So the voltage VB1 is shared between VBE2 and the resistor R2. So we can say that VBE1 is larger than VBE2, and if the two transistors are built equal, so with IS1 equal IS2, we get that IC2 is smaller than IC1. So we get a smaller output current. The voltage drop on the resistor R2 is the difference of the two base emitter voltages, which is equal to the thermal voltage times the logarithm of IC1 over IC2. If the base currents of the two transistors are neglected for simplicity, the resistor R2 can be found in this way, or in our example, in this way. One interesting feature of the circuit is that for VCC much larger than VBE1 and IC1 much larger than IC2, the output current will vary roughly as the logarithm of the supply voltage VCC, so it is relatively independent of the supply voltages. Now, let's see an example taken from the book Microelectronic Circuits by A. Cedra and K. Smith to better appreciate the working of the Widlar current source. Let's say we want to generate a current of 10 microamps with a classical current mirror on the left and with a Widlar current source on the right, assuming VBE equals 0.7 volt at a current of 1 milliamps and neglecting the beta. So we can say that 0.7 volt is equal this, but we want to find the VBE for 10 microamps, because in the classical current mirror, if Q1 and Q2 are matched, the current in the two branches are equal. Making the difference of these two equations, we get that VBE for 10 microamps is equal to 0.58 volts, and in this case, VBE1 is equal to VBE2. Knowing that VBE is 0.58 volts, we can get R1, which is equal to 942 kiloohms, a large value for an integrated circuit. Using the Widlar current source on the right, we can leave VBE1 at 0.7 volts, getting IRF equals 1 milliamps. So R2 is equal to 9.3 kiloohms, and R3 is equal to 11.5 kiloohms. So you can see we obtain a current of 10 microamps using resistors around 10 kiloohms instead of 1 megaohms. One typical example of a Widlar current source is the MUA741 operational amplifier, in which Dave Fullager uses it for the biasing circuit. In the op-amps, you need a small biasing current in the first stage and a much larger current in the second stage, so a Widlar current source is perfect to get both biasing currents. This is the branch where the current is produced. Q12 and Q11 are in transdiode configuration, so the current here is equal to 733 microamps, assuming VCC plus 15 volts and VEE negative 15 volts. The reference current is then mirrored towards the first stage by this Widlar current mirror consisting of Q11, Q10 and R4. The current flowing in Q10 is calculated solving this equation and it is equal to 19 microamps. I leave in the description a link for a very detailed video about the history and the working of the MUA741 operational amplifier. In the 555 integrated circuit, we find another example of Widlar current mirror. Here, the couple Q19-Q9 is used to scale down the current for biasing the trigger comparator composed by the PMP Darlington's Q10 to Q13. We want a low current to bias the trigger comparator because we want a small base current or a small current in the trigger input. The PMP at the time were poor with a low beta, so to lower the trigger input current, we lower the whole bias current. The 555 trigger comparator is composed by a PMP Darlington differential pair with a 100 kOhms resistor as load. The tail current is provided by a Widlar current mirror composed by Q19 and Q9. The tail current I9 is found solving this equation where 1.72 milliamps is the current flowing in Q19. This equation can be solved in iterative mode. We start assuming 100 millivolts dropping on R4, so I9 becomes 100 microamps. Putting 100 microamps in the formula, we get I9 equals 73.9 microamps. Now we put this new value in the formula and we get 81.8 microamps. Keeping doing this, we get this behavior where we see the result converges to 79.8 microamps. So I9, the output current of the Widlar current mirror, is equal to 79.8 microamps. I leave in the description a link about a detailed description about the history and the working of the 555 integrated circuit. It can be seen that the meter base voltage differential is a linear function of absolute temperature. Therefore, it might be expected that the output current of the current source would vary in a similar manner. Such is the case as illustrated here. The plot is for IC1 equals 50 times IC2, with both zero temperature coefficient resistors and high resistivity diffused resistors. It is notable that diffused resistors provide overcompensation for this characteristic. This comment from the Widlar paper of 1965 is the base for another Widlar legacy, the bandgap reference, about which I leave a link in the description. Please leave me a comment, let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put a thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.